Hey guys, welcome back to the next video, and this is Richard from WELSHYTECH. If you're new to the channel, welcome. And today we have got something from GAMDIAS. It is the Boreas P2-62 Digital. Yes, it has a screen. Okay, so this is a new cooler from GAMDIAS. Sorry if I pronounced that wrong. But this is a CPU cooler similar to what Thermalright and Deepcool are doing with screens. It's the Boreas P2-62D CPU cooler. And they say by here, sleek, magnetic, digital screen, CPU cooler and fan speed display, outstanding dual tower cooler performance, high quality 6 heat pipe solution, and 2 optimized 120 PWM fans. So let's get this unboxed and have a look, shall we? As you can see, it's still wrapped. I gotta wait. See, I can't just jump in and just unbox things. I gotta wait for you guys. So let's have a look. Oh, and there comes a QR code for the user manual. Awesome. So this will be a little guide. This will probably show you what's included. It'll tell you the include accessories, what CPU supports, actually show you how to install it as well. So what's the point in that? I don't know if they've already got one in the included packaging, but I don't know. Okay, so if I grab this now, I don't want to damage anything. Oh, okay. Okay, so where are the accessories? Aha. Okay, so we'll have a look at the fans now. Oh, so they are just standard fans. Look cool. Really nice. I like the blackout design. We'll get this one done. There we go. Out of the way. We'll get the cooler right here, which is... Ooh, wow. That's quite weighty, to be honest. Ooh. Looks very similar to the Deepcool AK620s I just reviewed. So they look very similar, quite honestly. So let's get all the packaging out of the way and we'll have a closer look. Okay, so these are standard PWM fans. I'm assuming they have got a hydraulic bearing. Oh, okay. Hydraulic bearings. They are, they seem okay. They do have a daisy chainable end, which is quite cool. That's actually handy for users. So it's only for that fan. Now let's get to the accessories. I will show you the cooler itself, which is obviously with a USB 2 header, which you do have to plug into your motherboard. So we'll have a look at that now. Let's have a look at the accessories, which are all here. Okay, so it's got your back plate, it's got AMD, it comes with thermal paste and a spreader, which is quite cool. And then, of course, it's got all your mounting brackets for AMD and Intel, which it obviously does support. So now let's take a look at the screen. Okay, so there's the screen. Now, this should just come off. Yeah, magnetized, which is very cool. I do like that. It's a lot easier for you because you can just take it off and done. So, yeah, it's quite cool. I like it. Now, like, this has got 6 heat pipes, which are, I mean, what are they, 6 millimeter or 4 millimeter thick heat pipes? That's what they looked like. And, of course, then you've got the base by here. Very nice. So, let's have a look at the overall specs. Now, the heatsink itself is 120, 104, and 160 millimeters tall. So that will obviously be with that. So the aluminium fins, 6 copper heat pipes. The fan dimensions are 120, 120 by 25. So basically, standard 120 millimeter fan. The fan speed does range between 800 and 2000 RPM with a 80.83 CFM, which isn't bad. That's actually quite high. And then the air pressure then is at 2.80 millimeter H2O. The noise level, they do rate between 10 and 32 dB. Hydraulic bearing, like I said, rated voltage is 12 volts, 4-pin PWM. And then when it comes to the overall CPUs it supports, it's LGA 1851, 1700, 1200, 1151, 1150, 1155, 1156, AM5, and AM4. So let's get this installed and see how it performs, shall we? Okay, so this is the installation And as for how you install it, now it's going to come with four standoffs, or four plastic standoffs, and here they are. Now these are four plastic standoffs, as you can see I've already used it, but what you want to really do is just put these each side like this. Now what I will say is that they do actually mention this in the installation guide, which is already provided for you in the box, but I'm going to show you how to do it anyway. Now, as for the bracketry, the brackets, you get four screws and you get these two brackets. Now, for AMD specifically, this you want pointed outward because this is how you're going to mount it. Now, this is a bit of a tip from me. Take the bracket, put the screws already in there with that there. Now, of course, while the CPU's there, it's not moving the backplate. If this was AM4, now you'd have to do it completely differently. You'd have to hold the backplate or do it a different way. But this way, you can get the screw situated. All you do is screw down one side below, like that. You screw it down until it stops, and you repeat it the other side. Now, the other side's exactly the same, just like this, and it will be the outer holes for AM5 and AM4. So remember, it's not like that on this side now, it's actually like that. So you want both of them facing each exact way. Now we put the screws in the holes like that. Now sometimes you might want to just tighten it a little with your hand. That is just for a little bit of it's personal preference really. You can either do it the way I do it, or you can just do one side at a time. It's not really a bother, because this is an AM4 where you have to would have had to hold the backplate as well. But that's installed. Now, thermal paste. Okay, so this is polymer therm. This is the X10 variant. They do have an X8 as well. This is the thermal paste I use for all of my testing. So let's do the application. Now, application is going to be very different whether you like it or not, but me personally, I just put it right in the middle of the CPU, just like that, and then I'll just put a little bit there just so it spread evenly. But generally that's about enough. It obviously, years ago, it used to be different. You'd have to put maybe a grain of rice size on the cooler itself. Now what you do is, to mount it, you take the cooler like this and it will be like that. Now the best way to do it really is get one already situated on the end of the thread, and then get the other one, leave it there. Now that won't move, that will stay there now until you get a long screwdriver. So I can't use what I was just using, but I can use a very long screwdriver. Now this isn't so much about spreading the thermal paste, because if it had a 4 point of contact, then the spread would be 100% even, but this is all about just getting the tension correctly and also making sure one side isn't drooping to one side. Now what you want to do really is start tightening it down from each side, and this will just bottom out because it does have a screw, so spring on the end of these screws and the threads, so it will just bottom out and basically screw it until it's done, and then that's it pretty much. Now as for like installing the fan, it's very straightforward, just basically like this. You put clips on each side, and then you put this one in the middle like that, and then you just repeat the exact same thing you just did with there. And this is the little display, you pull that there. Now I will show you where that cable goes, but that is it for the cooler. So let's show you where the cable for this goes to. Okay, so you're going to see a header right there, and it does say USB on it. Now the next port across, that is where I've actually put the this is a USB 2 header. This is what controls the screen, or allows you to control it. Now depending on the motherboard, you might have more than one or two USB ports, which you'll see, but there it just marks USB. These are the USB 2 head ports. Then all you do is just plug this in, and that is how you get it to work with the software that you'll have to install. We'll be right back. This is the GAMDIAS Boreas P2-62 Digital at 50% fan speed. At 50%, it's very quiet. Same thing, but 100% fan speed. It's quite loud at 100%. Okay then, so when it comes to the overall system I use for testing, it is my AM5 platform. It's an AMD Ryzen 9 7900 with PBO enabled. It's got a B650 motherboard. It's got 16 gigs of DDR5. It's got an RX 7800 XT Nitro Plus. It is housed in the Shadow Base 800 FX from Be Quiet, and it has a 1000-watt Kolink power supply. Now, as for the room temperature before testing, it was 18 Celsius, and the room did go up to 22 Celsius after testing. So, as for testing methods, I use the exact same runner benchmarks I do in every single CPU cooler review. That's Cinebench, Blender Pavilion, Blender Classroom, and 3D Master Test. Why? It's because it hits the CPU different through each different test. So, 50% fan speed, the CPU power draw at that time, the highs was 154 watts, with a low of 139. The CPU clocks were 5.4, with a low at 4.9, the lowest I've ever seen. And as for the thermal results, now, Cinebench R23, the idles are 38, with a max of 95 Celsius. That's the highest thermals I've ever seen on this particular CPU. Now, Blender Pavilion, the idles again, 38 with a max of 94. Blender Classroom, the idles are 38 with a max of 94 Celsius once again. And 3D Mark Test, the idles are 34 with a max of 82 Celsius. So, for 100% fan speed, now this is the fans going 100%, that includes the fans in the case. The CPU draw power, power draw was a little bit higher at 161 watts, and the lows are also a little bit higher, only 1 watt. It was 115. Now the clocks were much higher as well at 5.4 with a 5 gigahertz at low. So at least you're not losing any performance there. So as for Cinebench R23, the idles were 37, so we've already lost a degree there, and the max was 88 Celsius. That is a very dramatic dramatic temperature difference, and I run that 3 times. The Blender Pavilion was idle 37 with a max of 88 again. Blender Classroom idles 37 with a max of 89. And 3D Mark Supertest, the idles are 37 with a max of 73 Celsius. So what I'm going to do right here is actually put up a graph showing you the how this stacks up against like the thermal right, maybe some of the thermal right coolers without the screens. I'm going to put in some of the deep tool digital versions as well. I'm going to put in some other big towers because this is classed as a dual tower and it's rather big. So I will be putting in a few of other popular CPU coolers on the market, especially dual towers, so actually see how this does perform on AM5 specifically. Okay then, so as for conclusion, personally it's not going to get a recommendation from me whether it performs well or not, but what I'm going to really say is that for the price, there's only one place I can find it. It's $113. Now, in my personal honest opinion, I don't really think it's worth that kind of money because you can get an AIO for that price. You're probably better off actually looking at the Aurora AIO that they have, because that one has a bigger screen. It's a lot better when it comes to the software. Talking about software, all you can really change is from Celsius to Fahrenheit, or you can just change it from CPU temps to GPU temps. I don't really see the point in having a tiny little screen when you're charging $113, but that's just my personal opinion, and you take from what you want, okay? Now, thermals, of course, this, yes, it's one of the worst I've actually tested so far, but it's definitely up there when it comes to like thermal right coolers. Some of them perform well, some of them don't. This is just one of them that don't perform very well. But, of course, I am testing on it on Intel. This is specifically for AMD. But I am getting an Intel platform in here to start testing coolers on as well. Maybe it'll fare better when it comes to Intel. But for now, I don't give it a recommendation because I just really think the price is rather high and all you get is a tiny little screen. So, yeah, that's just my honest opinion. And yeah, if I upset someone, I'm sorry, but that's just me giving my personal thoughts. Now, as for the subscriber that I met at TechMax, if I seemed a little bit wary or a little bit shocked, it's because I've never actually met a subscriber in life. So I'd like to say thank you to you for stopping by and saying hello to me. And if any of you see me on the street, just shout Welshy and I will respond. So yeah, now look, I've got another cooler from them that will be Saturday, so make sure you subscribe for that. I've got loads of stuff coming. I've got AMD motherboards. I've got an Intel specific motherboard to review. I've got a camera. I've got something come from Lexar. So make sure you subscribe because I've got absolute tons of stuff coming. And as always, I hope you guys have a fantastic week and weekend ahead of you. This is Richard Welshytech. Goodbye.